All right, how's this sound? Does it work now? Oh, okay. Yay, it works. Why do I always have sound issues every time? Hi, everybody. This is Joseph. I guess I should tell you that for me. Oh, shut up. Technical issues every time. Hi, everybody. Joseph King, professional animator, and I'm making a comic called Slaughter Squad. And today I'm gonna do a tutorial. That's not really, I don't know. I'm just gonna show you how I design a character. Check it out. Bam. Oh yeah, before I get into this, I'll just show you guys some cool stuff. Earthworm Jim. They're kickstarting, well, Indiegogoing, crowdfunding. So they're making a new game for this weird new system. Amico? I don't know about that. I'll give them the benefit of the doubt. I need to see something, but what I'm even more excited about this Earthworm Jim comic book. They raised $100,000 in 24 hours. Impressive. Oh, it's like you give people what they want and then they give you money? What? So that's awesome. Good job, Doug Tanopel. My childhood hero. Bringing back nostalgia. That's cool. I wonder how far they'll go. I'm gonna guess at least $500,000. Who knows? The sky's the limit. And then I saw this one, Shinobi Sasquatch, Book 1. This is from Cal Jameson. This one looks pretty neat. It's pretty weird. This reminds me of like Image Comics when they started in the 90s, just like really talented artists getting let loose and doing crazy weird ideas. So it's a Sasquatch that turns into a werewolf. And he fights, I don't know, what is this? What is even going on? There's a. Some creep chasing an half-naked woman through the forest. Some like horror movie stuff going on. I'm not familiar with this character at all. I'm just discovering this for the first time. Cool. They raised $14,000. There's 18 days left. Good job. Congrats. I saw this one. I missed this one. I think this one closed already. This is Chuck Dixon. Airboy. This looks pretty cool too. It's a cool story. Bringing back a golden age. Is this golden age? Yeah, this is the golden age. 1940s. And they rebooted it in the 80s and now they're rebooting again? Well, it's not a reboot, it's a continuation. That looks nice. Cool. So anyways, this is, what did I name this guy? Jasper? He's gonna, this is a character that's gonna show up in the next issue of Slaughter Squad. And he's another bull. And there's sort of a rivalry between him and Kilgore. So I started off with just doing some sketches, and I usually sketch out stuff on scraps of paper first, keep it really loose. And this one I didn't even draw the whole character, I just drew his head, because I was planning on kind of using the general body shape, using the same body shape as Kilgore, and that's gonna be kind of the general theme. Like, the different animals will basically have a really similar body shape, and then the faces will be where things are different. And then I already kind of roughed out that body shape here, and so I differentiated them by, you know, making his face pretty different. You know, I changed the mouth shape, the eyebrows. Jasper has like a little tuft of hair on top. His horns are a bit different shape. They're shorter, but they're got more, you know, a little thicker. And then his tail, he's got kind of a broken tail. So most of the, one of the kind of running themes is that pretty much every animal has some kind of scar or injury or something. And then I need to come up with, decide what kind of weapon he's gonna use. So the bulls are like kind of the heavies in this universe, so they're usually gonna be carrying some heavy weapons. And then I need to decide what kind of, he's gonna be wearing some kind of combat vest or something. So I need to decide on that. I'm gonna look up some reference there. yeah. All right, let me organize this a bit. Put all this in a reference folder. he's got Jasper here. He's got the same, like all the bovines have the same sort of ear design, like Kilgore, Daisy. We keep the characters consistent. So the trick is changing them enough so that they're interesting, but keeping some kind of some elements so they're kind of fit together. Before I get onto this, I should figure out his costume. So maybe I'll put a bandana on his. What should be his weapon of choice? Oh, I know what. This should be his. This is what he should be packing. Give him one of these bad boys. Oh, yeah. Wow, that's an airsoft gun. That's pretty cool. I'd give one of these bad boys. So these are all like props. Like in reality, you're not gonna be able to fire one of these guns from your feet. These things are insane. Like that, the scene you see in Predator, that I think they said the first time they tried it, it nearly ripped the guy's arm off. The power from that gun was so crazy. dexterity. Hooray! So this is the real deal. That's pretty cool. So, no way. This one is pretty cool, but it's too small. Looks a little wimpy. I want a full size minigun. All right, drop that in the reference folder. Is that tricky? Brightness to opacity. And then that's a nifty trick in Clip Studio. Brightness to opacity. Ooh, it automatically delete all the white stuff. And then flip that. No, I'm probably just going to trace this. So he actually has a bigger gun than Kilgore, huh? Oh my God. And then let's see, what kind of body armor am I going with? That's kind of neat with the shoulder pads. That would differentiate from Kilgore. Saturday, something like that. And you'll notice I have the Kilgore reference in there. Just dropped in. Just to make sure I'm not going too far astray. Save. Flat, so I'm actually going to add some volume here and make it look like it's wrapping around the arm. It's pretty easy to do, it doesn't take much. Just a little bit of extra effort to add a little more dimension to it. Apply that to everything, like the shoulders here, same thing, this collar around his neck, just a few extra lines, goes a long way. Let's see, should he wear gloves? Gloves or not? Hands. Always gotta. Hands and feet, hardest things to draw. Always gotta look up reference with hands. I just look at my own hands. Stands a little bit taller, whatever. Gilbert has some bigger little boobs. It's a little... It's a little too far back. Do it just a little bit. Alright, now for the really fun part, coloring. One of the nice things about coloring Clip Studio, you can just use the paint bucket and just drop the colors in pretty easily. It's a lot like, if you ever used Flash, it's a lot like Flash. Not a big fan of Flash these days, but the paint bucket tool was pretty nice. Should I lots of black noise. That would be an interesting contrast. Let me look at some cows. Get some inspiration. Having all those spots would be a pain. Real pain. What is that? Wait. No. I like that brown color. It's maybe white with brown spots. I kind of like that. It's pretty simple. Should all the bulls have red eyes? I Cooper and his robots. I'm gonna make that the same shade of red. Those balls, wow. Lasso. All right, it's looking pretty cool. And his name is Jasper the Bull. And I did a few little sketches for the next book. Where did I put it? Here. So this is the initial sketch. And then they're gonna have a little fight scene. It's a friendly hustle. They're not trying to kill each other. Notice they cap the ends of their horns so they don't gore each other. Some bad guys. Some more sketches. Yeah, so there's Jasper. Alright. How long have I been streaming? Oh, it's been an hour. Nice. I think, yeah, that's perfect timing. Alright. I'm gonna call it 1 hour in. Happy Mother's Day. Belated Mother's Day to everybody. Happy Mother's Day. Alright, thanks for tuning in, everybody. Hope you learned something, and if you have any questions, just leave a comment or message me on Facebook or Twitter, and I'll probably respond. All right, see you guys next time. Peace out.